Well, I got a Tahan here. So it's one of the 25th anniversary models, so I guess it's probably 5 years old or something like that. It's got the label on it, you know, that says 25th anniversary. I've got a 10x12 SCF coil on it, and I've been doing some air testing with it here the last week, and I was wanting to show you the depth that this 10x12 gets on a nickel. And I've made me up a little label here. You can see I've 17, 18, 19 inches all the way up to 22. And you can see here it lines up right with the tape measure here. But I'm just gonna turn it on. And get it up here to, I got it set on. Just on foil on the discriminator, and I got the sensitivity up. Let me, that camera sort of makes it go crazy. Turn the sensitivity up to it, just gets right on the edge of becoming unstable. And let me see if I can get this nickel out of my pocket here and see if you can hear it when I start checking it. It hits good at 19. Don't know if you can hear it. But you get back to about 20. 20 and a half. It just barely chirps. But at 20, it hits real good. I mean, up here, 18, it's perfect. But when you got the headphones on, you can hear it back here in the 20 range. But that's just a lot of depth for that coil. I mean, it's astounding how much depth it's getting. Compared to the stock coil gets up around 16 max, 17 right in there. So this thing's adding 3 to 4 more inches of depth, just the 10x12. And it's not a whole lot heavier. And actually it IDs iron a whole lot better than the stock coil. It gives it more of a broken target on iron. So I just thought I'd pass it along. Anybody that's been on the fence about a 10x12, it's a great coil, sort of pricey, but I believe it would open up some new sites. I'm going to get out with it next week and just see what it'll do in the ground. I've always liked the Tahans for their ability to sniff out low conductors and at reasonable depth too, even in bad dirt. And I believe this new coil is really going to take it to the next level. So we'll just wait and see. But okay, I just wanted to show everybody the depth this thing does get, and that is also with about 5 or 6 beeps. If you put some good batteries in there, some lithiums, get it up to about 10 beeps, you'll get a lot more audio, should I say volume, out of it. On the deeper stuff, you'll probably get into the 20 inch range with a good solid beep. But okay, we'll just see how this comes out. Appreciate it.